once a mysterious industry, all the wild antics and hilarious hijinks that take place in the porn business are now regularly exposed for the world to see on True TV's hit show Hardcore Porn.
That's right. And the Gold family, owners of the largest pawn shop in Detroit, are at the center of all the drama. And joining us now with the scoop on season 9 is Seth Gold. Welcome to the show.
Good to see you, Seth.
Thank you.
Season 9, that in itself speaks to the success of this show. It's True TV's biggest show, top-rated show. Did you have any idea at the very beginning that it was going to last this long, it was going to be this big?
No, it was funny because I was the one who got the phone call. I had a producer call me up and was like, hey, Seth, I got a great idea for a reality show.
Yeah.
And I was like, what's that? He goes, us follow you around. And I hung up the phone. I was like, no, I'm not interested whatsoever.
Like, no way.
No way, right? So then my dad, I walked to my dad's office. And I was like, Dad, you know, it's so weird. I just got a call for a TV show. And his response is, how big can it possibly get? Let's give it a chance. So next thing you know, we had we shot one sizzle, like little 6-minute sizzle reel, and then went to pilot. And then at that point, me and my sister, we don't really agree on a lot of the things, but
we know.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Exactly.
We see that in the show.
So we said, like, we're not interested. Like, we're done. Mm-hmm. And my dad goes, well, I'm doing it whether you want to or not. So there you go. You know who calls the shots there? He's president. He doesn't have a problem.
And he's the boss. Yeah, exactly.
He's the boss. Yeah. He's the boss.
Okay.
But it proves well for TV, you know, and it keeps going. And you know, there's a lot of different elements which people can attach themselves to. And I think that's what keeps the show going.
All right, well, let's take a look at the show and then come back and talk more.
Yeah.
Old school air hockey table, huh?
This is a 68 to the 1970 Coleco. You even have the original paperwork.
You guys related?
Yeah, I'm his grandson, actually.
You're his grandson. So how much you guys want?
$320.
You can buy like a brand new one for that price.
No, they're over $700.
But this is a 1968. This is old.
This is vintage. This is good stuff.
Nobody wants vintage in like the world of air hockey. Everything is here, but really, you gotta come down your price a lot. So how about $50?
How about $275?
It's not gonna happen. I've seen them here in the past. They sit for a while. $60?
Give me 1¼.
I'll play you.
I like it.
You like it? See, there you go. And we'll go 80 and 50.
It's up to you.
Let's have some fun.
You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, so what are we playing to? First up to 3. Let's do it. Let's go.
All right, let's
go. Let's go. Ah, look at this thing. Don't think so, homie. One for the good guy. There you go, man. I thought he's like the champion of everything. Oh, look at that dribbling. Oh, there's 2. Whoa! 1 more, that's all I need.
I'm just
he's a little nervous. He's a little nervous.
Look at
coming
that.
Back.
His arm's getting tired.
My arm's getting really tired. Really?
Oh, see,
there you go.
I don't think that was fair. You forgot to tell him you were an air hockey champion.
Oh, yeah. No, see, the other one has brought the table, so I thought they had the definite advantage. But what happens? We ended up winning 1, so it was good.
That was just a little bit of the shenanigans that go on in the shop. What can we expect this season on the
show? You know, I think it's a lot of what the viewers used to. Me fighting with my sister, there's a new... my cousin came in the store, and so she's kind of ruffling a little bit of feathers, too. So big items, though. So what the viewer hasn't seen is a lot of high-dollar amount items. And this season in particular, you're going to see one of the biggest loans we ever processed. And a really cool item comes in the shop.
How much we talking?
Interesting.
We're talking almost 6 figures.
Woo!
Yeah, just for a loan, too. So, I mean, you know, we're always surprised with the amount of different kinds of merchandise that comes in, and so.
Can you tell us what it was?
It was an automobile. So now I'm giving a little too much, but it was a certain kind of car. But yeah, it was a car, so it was very cool.
I want to talk about what the show has done for the porn industry in general, because there have been a lot of negative stereotypes attached to the industry, right? Misperceptions or truths, maybe in some cases. What do you think the show has done overall for the industry, and has it cleared some of these things up?
So I definitely think it's benefited the industry. So now people are hip to save money. So whether it's you saying you bought a snow blower at a pawn shop, it's cool to save money. So now I kind of think that people don't have that hang their head down kind of feeling when they go in the pawn shop. It's cool, walk in, see what they got. Yeah. Sometimes it's right up their alley and sometimes it's not. So it's really a diverse place where you can find a lot of cool merchandise. Yeah.
Well, are you ever afraid that you will not be able to resell some of these items?
You know, so let me ask you, out of 10 people to get loans with me, how many do you think come back and pick up their merchandise?
10 people?
Yeah, what do you say?
5, maybe.
8.
Exactly.
Really?
Oh, really?
Yeah, 80 to 90% come back and pick up their merchandise. So we bet on the customer coming back. It's a worst case scenario when they don't, because I lose a customer, I get their stuff, and then I have to resell it. So, you know, my bet is that they're gonna come back. If we don't sell it, well, we sell everything in the shop eventually. There's always gonna be a buyer. So I'll give my dad a little bit of credit. He always says if someone bought it once, someone will buy it again. So, you know, that's how we kind of operate.
I'm glad you're giving your dad some credit, because you guys are always bumping heads. You guys are constantly fighting. You're the young guy coming new blood. He's like old school, we do it this way. Yeah. What are some of your ideas to revolutionize the company?
You know, my dad's so set on brick and mortar stores that he just, everything's in Detroit. Everything's in Detroit. Well, I opened up the e-commerce site on our for our store. So there's new ways of breaking through. I was just at CES last month.
I know.
Right?
I was reading about that.
Yes.
Because you were saying that electronics sooner or later are going to end up in your store, right?
Right.
90 days.
Exactly.
You can talk to us about that.
You did. Exactly. So it's 90 days out. So usually if something hits a big box store, we'll see it 90 days after, and I need the price accordingly. So that means when someone brings me in a TV, I already know that there's going to be some new technology advances, and you're not going to see as much as you normally would if you bought it retail. So it's one of those things that you have to be on the edge, and you have to see what's coming down the pipeline.
Yeah. One of the things I love seeing come down the pipeline on the show are all the crazy characters of people that walk into the shop. Where do you find
Wild
these people? I'm like,
wonderful.
Do they pay these people? This is not true.
You know, are we talking about my family?
Besides the family, all the other
people. The guy with the cat tattoo, he wanted his stuffed cat back. That was hilarious.
Yeah. You know, it's
real?
All types. Yeah, so what you see is what you get. So we write about 1,000 loans a day.
Wow.
Every day, someone, like 1,000 people come in the store. So you're not going to see the easy transactions. I mean, that doesn't make good TV. You're going to see the most exciting transactions that we get through the day.
And we will see tonight.
Tonight,
9:30 on True TV, the second episode of the ninth season.
And as hardcore pawn people.
Pawn shop. Okay.
Let's get that right. Thank you so much for joining us, and congratulations on the success of the show.
Thank you, guys,
Seth.
All right, we'll be right back with more Rise 360.